I think as a practice, we've welcomed enormously the concept and title of the Free Space Biennale. I believe that this is a very important time to consider architecture's societal contribution. We know that every project comes with its own program, and the program is normally defining the functional needs of the client being the person who's commissioning the project. But increasingly we understand that this is not our only client. The client is also the passerby, the occupant, the temporary visitor. So how does architecture deal with its own responsibilities programmatically, and in a way deal with responsibilities which are not prescribed from a professional point of view, from a strictly professional point of view, but on the other hand are fundamental to architecture. The brief for the Biennale is very explicit about this, and we fully agree with the sentiments. And in our own work, we always try to see to what degree a building can go beyond its pure internal responsibilities, to what degree can it contribute. And at a time when we might say that the constraints or the encouragements of a wider and more proactive planning environment are suffering, let's say, then it becomes more and more incumbent on singular buildings to try to offer, to reach out from their core program, to become, to make gestures, to make public gestures and gestures which contribute to the cumulative quality of the city. In the project that we show, we sort of revert, first of all, to an image that we have become over these last 20 years incredibly fond of, having worked on the museum island in Berlin all this time. We always return to this one image of Carl Friedrich Schinkel. It's an image drawn from the upper balcony of the Altes Museum, looking back through the colonnade of the Altes Museum, this fantastic gesture, this public gesture, to the Lustgarten and, in fact, to the Schloss beyond. The figures that stand on this balcony, the top of the staircase, are citizens who are visiting this public building. They are standing inside a building. They have gone up steps, they've passed through columns, they've gone up a staircase, but they've never passed through a door. They are embraced by the building. The building has, in a way, absorbed public space into it. And this is a really, especially when you think of when this was built, an incredible gesture towards the terrain of the sort of civic territory, that you make this treasure box of culture an extension of the public realm. And this inspired us through our work in the Museum Island, most specifically on our project at the James Simon Gallery, where we had a shopping list of requirements that had to go into the building, but we struggled to make a building out of this shopping list. And it was only when we liberated ourselves to say, well, what does it want to be? What is the real purpose of this building? It's not, the purpose is not given by the sum of its parts, by these the auditorium, the temporary exhibition space, the coffee shop. It's given by the gesture it will make, it needs to make to the public as a sort of entrance building, as a connector, as a device which ties together the museum island. In fact, it's tied together by free space. It's tied together by a space which is in a way slightly free of program. The program is in a way slightly condensed, and in a way pushed down as hard as we can in order to liberate the free space, which becomes the real purpose of building, the place of collection, of congregation, of orientation, and of public gesture.